Good morning. How's everybody doing today? All right, small but proud. So I have a few questions to start with. How many of you want to one day be recognized as a leader or be in a leadership position in surgery? Raise your hand. Almost everybody in the room, few exceptions. How many of you think you've already become a leader in your profession? A few. There's a gap between those two. How many of you have thought about changing jobs or have changed jobs because you felt you couldn't move into a leadership role? A number of you. So there's a gap. There's a gap between what you want to be, a surgical leader, and where you are now and how you're going to get there. So we're going to talk a little bit about how you might fill that gap. So good news, cancel your moving truck. You do not need to necessarily move jobs. And stop feeling like you have to change jobs to advance or become a leader. The answer to closing that gap and building your skill set to become a leader in surgery is right here. Literally, right here, right now. It's the conference you're attending. It's the organization putting it on. It's SAGES and the Association of Women Surgeons and the American College of Surgeons and almost any other professional organization that has education sessions, research presentations, committees, and a board where its leadership comes from its membership. It's far less likely that your leadership role is going to come in your place of employment. In fact, Scott Huntington, who's an author who studies career development, argues that the workplace isn't really the best place to try out your leadership skills. He says, if your role doesn't call for it, attempting to thrust yourself forward can be a dicey proposition, especially for a more junior employee. It can lead to interpersonal conflict between your colleagues. It encourages an unhealthy work-life balance as you try and do more in a short period of time. And it can even place your career at risk if you make a very visible mistake that impacts your colleagues. So instead, many of us would benefit from what would be our own mirror dimensions. Any Dr. Strange fans out there? Anyone? What was the mirror dimension? Anyone know? It was a safe place for Dr. Strange to practice his spells without harming the outside world. It's his practice environment. It was okay to make a mistake there, and you generally are not going to lose your job for making the mistake. So professional organizations and committees and conferences generally provide that safe, challenging, but positive environment where you can build your leadership skills separate from where you practice clinical patient care. So how do you get started on that pathway? First, you got to show up. Woody Allen, 80% of success is just showing up. So join 2, 3, 4 professional organizations where you can be a member and choose 2, 3, 4 conferences a year that you'd enjoy where you can have the opportunity to get involved, and attending those conferences has to be your priority if you want to be a leader. In general, smaller organizations will allow you to make a bigger impact quickly, but bigger organizations are going to challenge you more. So I was given my start in leadership in the Association of Women Surgeons, which around the time had about 600 members. I was a third-year surgery resident, and I was hunting for a grant to pay for a small research project that I was doing in the lab, and I applied for the grant offered by the AWS. And so I was lucky enough to get it, and I went to my first AWS meeting, i.e., I showed up just to get the grant. And when I looked at their board, I noticed they didn't have a resident on it. So I went to the organization's president that year, Dr. Lee Neumeier, who turned around and said, "So, do you want to be the resident on the board?" And I said, "Yes." So 14 years later, I became president of the then 1,700-member Association of Women Surgeons. You see a problem, you provide a solution, and suddenly you become a leader. So step one is showing up and saying yes. But second, when you're at the meeting, you gotta network, okay? It's not enough to go to the educational events and then curl up in your room come 5 o'clock when they end. I'm talking to, you introverts in the audience. I know that. I love that feeling. I'm one of you. Last presentation done. Head to the comfy bed. Skip the scheduled dinner and decide on room service and Netflix. But it's a wasted opportunity, all right? Conferences are the time to invest in your career. Grab a plate, sit down at a random table for breakfast, step out of your comfort zone, start conversations with strangers. Walk up to people with ribbons on their name badge and introduce yourself. Tell them you want to get involved. Ask if they know any projects looking for volunteers. Be brave, or at least don't know the meaning of the word fear. Heck, there's a lot of words I don't know the meaning of, but that's not one of them. What I do know is that just talking to other people at conferences is the first step to building a network of people who can then build your national reputation. You'll often be surprised that the ribbon badge leaders really want to get involved, and they actually really want to advance your career. Jack Welch once said, "Before you're a leader, success is all about growing yourself. But once you become a leader, success is all about growing others." So for the senior leaders in the room, your national presence is now more about helping others with their success than it is your own. It's suggesting the junior person to serve on the panel when you're asked instead. It's connecting people at different institutions to help accelerate their careers. It's about making a broader impact on the careers of others than on your own career. David Ratner was the person who did that for me. He had me join SAGES back as an intern back in 1995. And when I attended my first SAGES conference after completing all my training, he had me put on the SAGES Pediatric Liaison Committee. 15 years later, I've been chair of that committee for 2 terms. I'm entering my 2nd term on the Board of Governors. I've organized the SAGES Manual for Pediatric Surgery. I've been a co-author on a couple other SAGES papers. And I'm continuing to learn and grow and love from my SAGES family. And now I try and push forth others for those roles. For the junior members of the audience, don't let those who point you in those opportunities down. So you have to do the work, you have to solve the problem, you have to come to the meeting, you have to phone into it, you have to write the paper and submit the abstract or complete whatever opportunity was thrust your way. But it's much easier than hiring a moving truck to move to a new job. It's the hard work side of the learning curve where you'll likely do more putting in than you are taking out, but be patient. Because when you do a good job with one task, they'll give you another, and for the next, and quickly you'll find yourself with more opportunities than you could possibly take on at once. Pretty soon you're on the committee, with time and effort, you become leadership on that committee, and maybe even a little higher, like a board or an officer, and pretty soon you have a national presence. You have become a leader, no moving truck involved. One of the other beauties of professional organizations is they're really good at recognition for work. In fact, recognition is far more likely to occur outside your place of employment than in it. And as Mark Twain once said, I can live a good 2 months on a good compliment. This is a wonderful recipe for treating burnout, actually getting praised and recognized for the hard work you do. You do hard work, you present in a forum of your peers, your name is put in print in the journal, you get it in the program as a committee member or a session moderator, and you get public thanks for what you do up here on a stage. Everyone's a winner. The only thing missing is the paycheck that goes with it. SAGES is particularly good about recognizing people who do hard work, and so I'm going to actually take a minute to do that right now. Every member of the board is given 2 of these coins. These are SAGES coins for excellence, and they're to thank people who do a good job, who put time and effort into SAGES. And right now I'd like to call Dr. Angela Hanna to the stage. Dr. Hanna is a pediatric surgeon who's been dutifully serving on the pediatric committee for a while. She also contributed to the Safe Coli modules at SAGES this year. She helped participate and authored chapters for the SAGES Manual on Pediatric Surgery. And yesterday, she volunteered to help put together a grant offering talking about the transition from pediatric surgery to adult surgery for grant application. And in recognition of your honor, your work for SAGES, I'd like to thank you and present you with this certificate and coin of appreciation. Thank you, Dr. Hanna. It's that easy. It's that easy. You get recognition when you do a good job in an organization. So with time, your CV is growing, your skill set is growing, and people start contacting you about those jobs for advancement. Finally, you're in those leadership positions you aspire to. It seems that the measure of success in an employment is actually often the duration of time with which you hold the position. Dr. Smith has been chair of surgery for the last 22 years now. But in surgery organizations, leaders are like baby diapers. They get changed regularly, and for the same reason. 1 year as president and out, clean diaper. So leaders are appointed almost every year, and the opportunity to lead comes around that much faster because of it. So in summary, if you're here in the audience today, you've already taken the big step toward creating your national presence. 80% credit, you showed up. When you leave this session today, I encourage you to take the next step. Walk up to the leaders, go to the SAGE's headquarters booth, get involved and volunteer to do work. And if not in SAGE's, then with some other organization which you identify. But when you get the opportunity, take it and run with it. For the established leaders in the group, become known as the person who advances the careers of others. Give others the much needed opportunity to practice their leadership skills in this mirror dimension known as professional organizations. When Dr. Strange was thrust into leadership, he said, "I'm not ready." And his mentor replied, "No one ever is. So forget fear, carpe diem, seize the day, and good luck in your quest for leadership." Thank you.